before.
Come
me.
On now.
5 minutes, Uncle Billy.
Have your beer.
5 minutes to closing time.
5 minutes. Closing time.
Hello, sweetheart. Yes, for the tune, eh?
Here, you're hard luck, that's what you are.
Here, you're a bad matey, let's have a look at it. Blimey.
Hey, what can I get you, lad?
Mother's ruin. Make mine the same.
It'll cost you 2 bob for that broken glass, matey.
What's the idea anyway, letting a beast like that fly around loose in the public house?
You didn't order to let him smell the blood. He's very fond of blood, Charlie is.
Comes by his taste natural, if you ask me.
Nobody's asking you, miss.
Oh.
Where's he from?
Musgrave Manor.
What is this Musgrave Manor, a blinking prison?
That ain't the worst it's been called. Not that I'm one to go about spreading stories. But we knows what we knows. Don't we, Charlie?
Blimey. Where is this Musgrave Manor?
Down the road a piece. You'll see it when you pass the old iron gates. Only don't loiter. You won't be welcome. Not by the Musgraves. Been sitting there. Lords of the manor ever since time was. If those old walls could speak, they'd tell you things that raise the hair on your head. There's folks hereabouts swear they've seen corpse lights round the old greenhouse. And heard a wailing like lost souls in the lime walk. Hey, I want no part of it. Nor of the Musgraves, neither. Hard men, like them as was before them. Cruel men. God pity them. For the day's coming when they'll need pity.
You're being quite fair, Geoffrey.
I assure you, I have no wish to be fair. An excellent specimen of the Copris Carolina.
You are a sweet old soul, aren't you?
I've no wish to be a sweet old soul. No wish to be anything but what I am. A disagreeable person who does not intend to let his sister run off with the first cocksure Yankee who makes her pulses jump.
And I suppose Philip feels the same way about it.
Well, Philip has no choice in the matter. As my younger brother, Philip feels precisely as I tell him to.
Eavesdropping again, Brunton?
Oh, no, Mr. Philip, I assure you. But I didn't wish to disturb him.
What did you hear, Brunton?
Your brother and Miss Sally were going at it hammer and tongs. About Captain Vickery, I mean.
Really?
Mr. Geoffrey and Captain Vickery had an horrible row this afternoon over Miss Sally. I thought they were coming to blows. Indeed, I did.
Quiet. That'll do now, Brunton. If I catch you snooping again, I shall ask my brother to give you notice.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
You're not above a bit of snooping yourself, are you, Philip?
Not in the least, old boy.
Oh, there you are. I've been ringing for you.
Sorry, Dr. Watson. I was in the upper region.
The library's in a filthy mess. The wind came swishing down the chimney and scattered the ashes everywhere.
Very well. I'll tidy it up at once, Doctor.
Room full of smoke, papers all over the floor. Foul night,
Brunton. It's customary in Elston, sir.
Just the sort of night, I fancy, for the ghost of Lady Clorinda.
Oh, no, Dr. Watson. Lady Clorinda only walks in the west wing. No one ever met a ghost in this part of the house.
Really? Isn't there some story that...
Oh, there was an housemaid claimed that she saw Sir Gervas Musgrave with his head on backwards in this very room.
Oh, gracious me.
Well, she was just a flighty girl, sir. Oh,
sounds like it. Very flighty.
A most.
Head on backwards. Head on backwards. It's a rubbish word. Mr. Branton, does the wind always carry on like this here?
Frequently, sir. It's a great pity. It makes the gentleman restless. More than usual, I mean.
Well, our patients are all tucked up for the night now, eh, Branton?
Are they?
Of course, of course. Well, aren't they?
Captain Vickery is in his room, sir. And it looked like Major Langford I saw going toward the pool. And I can't account for Lieutenant Clavering.
Really? It's very odd.
Very odd, sir. Anything else, sir?
No, thank you. Oh, yes, yes. You might tell Dr. Sexton that I'd like to see him for a minute, will you?
Very good, sir. Good night, sir.
Good night, Brunton.
Sorry.
Stiff. Get my bag, will you, Brunton?
Yes, sir.
Now, let's have a look.
It's a near thing. Just missed the carotid artery. Looks like a knife wound.
Here you are, sir.
Oh, it's like a nightmare.
Give me some of that cotton wool in that little bottle, please.
Awful nuisance.
Oh, no, old fellow. We'll have you patched up in no time. You'll be as good as new. What happened?
I hardly know. It was in Lime Walk just now. I was coming up from the village. I remember distinctly, I was approaching the greenhouse. The wind was terrific. I had to fight my way. I hadn't the slightest warning. All I know is that he struck and I went down. He must have thought I was done for.
Any idea who it was?
No. Well, that is, I...
Yes, yes.
Oh, really, I haven't any right.
You have every right, Dr. Sexton. As head of this house, I shall arrange for an immediate investigation.
Oh, I'd rather not, if you don't mind, sir.
Dr. Sexton, the fact that my brother and sister and I have opened our home to convalescent patients doesn't relieve us of all responsibility for what occurs in it.
I mean, under the peculiar circumstances.
Well, come along, Bob. There's no need to shield anyone.
Thirteen.
That's curious. What's got into the old clock?
Nothing, nothing at all.
Oh, sir, don't you remember the last time it did that? Your father was killed the next day.
Remember how fresh clothes used to smell when they hung out all day to dry? Introducing new Gain. We think we've come up with a detergent that actually leaves clothes smelling outdoor fresh right from the dryer. Let's see what women think.
I noticed it the minute I opened the dryer. They smell just like, a sea breeze. You know, when you're down at the shore. It's just a clean, fresh smell.
To me, they smell like a fresh meadow. Like being in a fresh meadow with the grass and the leaves. But it really lasts. That's nice.
It smells fresh. You know, like when you hang clothes out on the line and a fresh breeze blows them all day. It's just a clean smell, which is very surprising coming from a dryer.
New Gain. not only gets clothes clean, it leaves them smelling this outdoor fresh right from the dryer.
George,
the PTA is coming tonight.
You're serving your coffee?
No jokes about my coffee again. But he's right, Mrs. Olson. What can I do?
Here, try new Folger's flake coffee. It tastes delicious.
Heard about Folger's, but what's Folger's flake coffee?
Well, it's specially designed for automatic drip coffee makers.
Mountain grown?
That's the richest, most aromatic kind of coffee. And because it's flaked, Folger's releases more of its rich flavor, so you use less. If you normally use 5 measures per pot, you'll only need 4 measures of Folger's flaked coffee.
So this 13-ounce can makes as much as a pound.
You try it.
Hey, tastes rich. Delicious.
He's not joking.
New Folger's flaked coffee for automatic drip coffee makers. For other coffee makers, get Folger's in the red can. Both delicious mountain-grown Folger's.
Sunday evening, April 2nd, the Atlanta Flames play the Buffalo Sabres at 7 p.m. See the Flames at the Omni, April 1st and April 8th.
Scientific experiment, Mrs. Hudson.
Oh, frightening the witch out of honest people.
Permit me, ma'am.
Oh, dear. So now it's bullet holes in me plaster. Oh, Mr. Holmes, this is the last straw.
The last straw, Mrs. Hudson. The one which breaks the back of the case against Jacob Dill. It proves beyond a shadow of doubt that, even bound as he claims he was, he could still have fired the shot in his own defense that killed his wife's lover.
But shooting holes in my beautiful plaster.
Watson.
My dear fellow, I'm glad to find you in. I didn't even knock. How do you know it was me?
Me is acceptable, Watson, unless, of course, you're a purist, which I doubt. And may I add that your step is like no other in London. You're just in time for breakfast.
Good, I rather counted on that. Mrs. Hudson, dear, how are you?
Oh, it's good to see you again, sir. I think there'll be enough there for two.
Splendid.
You're a sight for sore eyes, Watson.
Thanks, old boy, and so are you.
Sit down.
Good, thank you.
All right, let's have it. What brings you from Northumberland at this early hour?
A bad business, Holmes. A very bad business. How do you know that I came from Northumberland?
The only train arriving at Euston Station at this hour is the Newcastle Express from Northumberland. Ergo, Sir Knight, thou comest from Northumberland.
Of course. Obvious, isn't it?
Quite. Now tell me. What dark deed was done at Hurston Towers last night?
Well, that's what I came to see about, Holmes. About 10 o'clock last night, I was sitting in the lab. How do you know that I came from Hurston?
You wrote me that you'd volunteered for medical service within the realm. With your experience, what post could have been offered you, other than to put you in charge of a home for convalescent officers? Only one such home has been opened in Northumberland in the last month, and that's Musgrave Manor at Hurston.
Simple reasoning. Child could do it.
Not your child, Watson.
No, of course. Well, I never had a child. I very nearly did, though. Did I ever tell you about that widow at Twickenham? Very narrow escape. I just found out in time she had a most horrible little squirt, about 3 and a half.
Yes, Watson, I think we'd better stick to Hurston.
Oh, sorry, what? Oh, Hurston. It's a grim old pile. Very spooky.
Don't tell me that you met a ghost.
No, not so spooky as that. Ghosts don't stab people the neck, do they? Or do they?
Not well-bred ghosts, Watson. Who was stabbed in the neck?
My young assistant, Dr. Sexton.
When?
Last night.
Any idea who did it?
No idea.
You reported it?
No, I didn't.
Why not?
Well, see, it was a...
My dear fellow, what you're trying to say is the officers in your care are all fine fellows, wonderful war records and so on. Is that it?
Precisely.
So you thought perhaps a private investigation?
Exactly.
Very right and proper thinking, Watson. We've just time to catch the 9:30 train for Hurlston.
Well, my dear fellow, there's no immediate hurry.
Isn't there? Your patients are all victims of combat fatigue. Any one of them might go over the edge at any moment. And from what you've told me, there's a killer loose at Hurlston.
Great Scott, you may be right.
Come on, Watson. We haven't a moment to lose. I only hope we shan't be too late.
You were right, Watson, about Musgrave Manor. Houses like people have definite personalities, and this place is positively ghoulish.
Certainly is.
Hello. What's that?
Just the old greenhouse?
No, that pile of leaves.
Just an ordinary pile of leaves. Why?
Doesn't it strike you as odd, Watson, that a pile of leaves should be raked up in front of a greenhouse door? No gardener in the world would do that.
That's all very interesting, Inspector Lestrade. But what, may I ask, does it prove?
What I'm trying to prove is this. The Dr. Sexton here went down...
Twice now, Inspector.
You were stunned.
Naturally.
You were out longer than you thought. That's the point.
What point?
Just this. The man who attacked him had time to get back into the house before Dr. Sexton here came to.
Yes?
Yes. And this here glove... Oh. And this here glove, what I picked up at the scene of the crime, belongs to a certain party right here in this house.
I say.
Why, that glove belongs to my brother.
Huh?
You suggest that he attempted to murder Dr. Sexton?
Who knows? The man whose hand fits this here glove will bear talking to.
Very well. My brother's down at the stables. I'll take you to him myself.
Thank you.
It's the quickest way to put a stop to this blithering nonsense. Come on.
Oh, Mr. Phillip.
Yeah?
Better not go out in the night air without a coat.
Here, take mine.
Thanks. And I won't need this.
No. Nor this.
Well, shall we go? Why, if it ain't Mr. Holmes.
Good evening, Lestrade.
Come to give us an hand, have you?
Always happy to help, Inspector.
Thanks, but I don't think I should be needing any. Why, if it isn't Dr. Watson.
Gentlemen, this is my friend, Mr. Sherlock Holmes. Mr. Philip Musgrave and Dr. Sexton.
How do you do?
How do you do?
I've just brought him up to spend a few days with us.
Well, that's very good of you. But as you see, Scotland Yard's already taken charge.
Oh, really? That's most unfortunate.
If you don't mind, Dr. Watson, I'd like to have that little talk with your brother, sir.
I'm afraid you can't have that pleasure, Inspector.
Oh, no?
I've got bad news for you, Mr. Musgrave. We've just found your brother in the Lime Walk. He's dead.
You can't mean it.
No.
Look here, Holmes, if this is one of your little jokes...
Murder's no joke, Inspector.
That's right, Mr. Holmes. No good saying it ain't. Murder? Well, let's get going.
I'll take charge now.
What?
It's quite within my rights as a local justice of the peace.
I'll come with you.
You fool. Don't go barging in like that.
Don't maul me.
Surgical instruments. You know, Watson, the instruments that save life are hardly more pleasant to look at than those that take it.
Grisly thought, Holmes.
You rang, Dr. Watson?
Yes, Brunton. I want you to take some men and go down to the Lime Walk.
Me, sir? Oh, I can't, sir. I'm sorry, but I simply can't. My stomach, you know. I really couldn't look at a corpse.
Corpse?
Well, I...
How did you know that there was a corpse?
Obviously, he was listening at the door.
I'll take care of the matter, Doctor. I was listening, too. Come along, Brunton.
Remarkable woman. Housekeeper, I suppose.
She's very efficient.
Same type as Mary Ann Carpenter, the trunk murderess. Extraordinary house.
Yes, it is indeed.
Now, Watson, if you don't mind, I'd like to have a word with your extraordinary patients.
Let me remind you, Holmes, that my patients are just patients.
Quite so.
All normal men, sound in mind and body, no sign of psychoneurosis.
I quite understand.
Then, Holmes, even normal people are sometimes a little...
Every day is a special day at Sterchi's Toco Hills Clearance Center, and that means drastically reduced prices on all our merchandise, like end tables and coffee tables as low as $58, bedroom suits starting at $298, and dining room suits as low as $398. Not only that, we've got sofas for as low as $128 and chairs as low as $48. Sterchi's opens at 10 a.m. each day and stays open late on Mondays and Fridays. Most items are one of a kind and subject to prior sale. So hurry to Sterchi's Toco Hills Shopping Center.
George Thompson Ford is ready to pay you $500 cash. That's right, $500 cash on the spot when you buy a new van. It's a $500 cash rebate that you put in your pocket. George Thompson Ford is van headquarters for the Southeast and has literally hundreds of models to choose from. Vans to live in, vans to travel in, vans to play in. This $500 cash rebate is a limited offer. You get your van, you put $500 in your pocket. It's the greatest van deal ever. George Thompson Ford, across from Greenbrier Shopping Center next to Kmart.
My tennis partner Jill bet me a new racket that her new roll-on would keep me drier than my Sure roll-on. I took the bet. Sure roll-on really worked for me. I lose. Her roll-on does keep me drier.
New improved Sure roll-on with a new, more effective formula that'll keep you drier than ever before.
I still win. New improved Sure roll-on keeps me drier. You lose some, you win some.
New improved Sure roll-on. You'll be drier.
Grandma, quick! Look!
What?
I'm beginning to see me. It's like the plate got all shiny all by itself.
Is that your mommy's lemon fresh joy? It's what makes her table always look so pretty.
I think I'll try on the green plate.
Okay.
Here I am again.
Pigtails. Okay, honey. Let's set the table for dinner.
Is it as pretty as mommy does it?
It's beautiful.
Lemon fresh joy cleans down to the shine. What a nice reflection on you.
Most bathroom tissues talk about softness. So how can you tell which one to buy? White Cloud proof there's no softer bathroom tissue on Earth. We'll convince you, we'll convince them.
This isn't softer than White Cloud either.
Convinced yet?
We got one more.
Convinced?
We're convinced.
Convinced?
Nothing softer than White Cloud.
Convince yourself. Compare your brand to White Cloud. There's nothing softer. You'll be convinced.
Hello, Mac.
I must have taken a wee nap.
Mac, I want you to meet a very old friend of mine, Mr. Sherlock Holmes, Captain McIntosh.
How do you do?
I have heard of you, Mr. Holmes.
Sorry to have wakened you.
Oh, that's quite all right.
See you later.
Yes.
Sit down, Mac, and go on with your sleep. Poor chap, he lay wounded in a trench on Joshua Hill. The German tanks went over him.
Watson.
Huh?
Have you any idea how Geoffrey Musgrave met his death?
Yes, depressed skull fracture. Only hang it all, Holmes, it isn't.
Isn't it? Why not?
No edema, no bleeding, no contraction of tissue.
Precisely. The blow on the head was delivered after death. Musgrave was killed by a sharp instrument thrust up between the base of the skull and the top vertebra.
Great Scott.
Should we go up now?
Langford.
Hello there. Been away, haven't you?
Yes, I've just been out of London. I brought my friend back. This is Mr. Sherlock Holmes, Major Langford.
See you at dinner. What?
I hope so.
Excuse me.
Poor chap was at Singapore. Escaped from a Japanese prison camp. Ghastly experience. He's suffering from...
Escape complex, obviously.
Yes, he's a very nice chap, though. The next fellow I want you to meet is young Clavering. Lieutenant, Royal Engineers. Saw a lot of men blown to bits by Nazi booby traps. He's a bit on edge.
Not unnaturally.
Coming. Well, Dr. Watson, come in, won't you? Sorry to keep you so long. You see, I was lying down, resting.
This is my friend, Mr. Holmes, who's here for a few days. Mr. Clavering.
Glad to meet you.
How do you do? Sorry to disturb you.
Not at all. I say, you don't have to have some cigarettes about you, do you?
That's one of the reasons I came. I brought you some of those American cigarettes that you're so fond of. That's all right. Open it up.
No hurry. No hurry at all.
No, no, no. Of course there isn't.
Here we go.
Yes, well, we must be off. We've got a lot to do.
See you later.
Yes, I'll be back.
Good night. He seemed afraid there might be a bomb in that package.
Well, he's found him in less likely places than that, poor chap. The man in this room is American flying officer, Captain Vickery. Nothing very much the matter with him.
What's he here for, then?
A spot of rest. Had a pretty long go of it, worn out. Needs all the rest he can get. Vickery? Vickery? Doesn't seem to be in. No one at home.
Down to not. Not since tea time, at any rate. Well, what's this? Captain Vickery, here's your tea. If it's cold, don't blame me.
That sounds like Brunton's work.
The butler?
He fancies himself a poet, but only when he's drinking.
I see. Wasn't there an American killer given to verse?
Holmes, you don't think that Brunton...
Excuse me. I merely stated there's an American killer given to verse.
Dr. Watson, oh, where are you? Oh, there you are.
Steady, my dear, steady.
Please make me wake up, won't you? It's just a bad dream, I know. Jeff and Pat...
No, 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 my dear, you've got to get a grip on yourself. Come on, come sit down.
My brother Jeff, murdered. Poor old Jeff. And I hadn't spoken to him since we had the fight yesterday on Captain Vickery's account. And now he's dead.
Now, now, my dear, you must pull yourself together.
But you don't understand. They're trying to say that Pat... They're trying to prove that Pat killed Jeff.
No, no, no.
Yes! Funny, isn't it? Awfully funny. Awfully funny. Awfully funny.
Stop it!
Who are you?
My name is Holmes.
Sherlock Holmes?
Yes.
Then you'll help us, won't you, Mr. Holmes? Pat and me.
I'll try to. Now, tell me. Wasn't there bad blood between your brother Jeffrey and Captain Vickery?
That's got nothing to do with it.
It may have everything to do with it.
If you think Captain Vickery ever murdered anyone, you're no more of a detective than Dr. Watson.
My dear.
Oh, I'm sorry.
You're very much in love, aren't you?
I'm out of my mind, Mr. Holmes. I'm out of my mind. Oh, please forgive me and please... Please help me.
Of course, I understand.
But you don't understand. That appalling man from Scotland Yard is questioning Pat at this very moment.
Now, this here rake, it's the identical one you got from the gardener this afternoon, now, ain't it?
Smells like it. Hey, what is this? Are you trying to prove that Jeffrey Musgrave was killed with a rake?
No, I'm trying to... Never mind what I'm trying to prove.
Just incriminate yourself, Captain Vickery. That's all Lestrade wants.
I'll thank you to keep out of this, Mr. Holmes.
This is Mr. Sherlock Holmes.
How do you do?
He's promised to help you, dear. There's nothing to worry about now.
Only his neck, miss. Now this here rake. What did you say you were using it for?
I told you, I got it to fish my cap out of the pond. It blew in.
Oh, so you were using it down at the pond, were you?
For the 10th time, yes.
And how did it happen to turn up alongside Musgrave's body, eh?
I don't know.
Uh-huh. Well, that's that.
Oh, Mr. Holmes.
Any fingerprints on the rake, Inspector?
No, Mr. Holmes, that's the point. If Vickery was only using it to fish his hat out, well, no, he wouldn't bother to wipe his fingerprints off, now would he?
It's beyond imagination, I suppose, that somebody else could have used the rake and wiped off both sets of fingerprints.
Highly interesting, but very unlikely. Now, you admit that you had a regular set to with Jeffrey Musgrave yesterday, didn't you? You threatened to bash his head in.
I merely made the offer. He didn't accept it.
Who told you so?
He did. No, he did.
I only stated what I heard. Captain Vickery did threaten my brother.
That's right, Mr. Holmes, and it's no good saying it ain't. This Yankee lad had motive and opportunity, and the rake ties him right up tight to the corpse.
All right. Come along.
New Gain leaves clothes smelling outdoor fresh right from the dryer. Incredible? Listen.
They smell fresh. You know, like after it's rained, it's just a clean smell. And it really lasts, even after the dryer.
Do you know how they smell? You know how fresh everything smells in the mountains? Well, that's how they smell. Clean and fresh.
New Gain not only gets clothes clean, it leaves them smelling outdoor fresh right from the dryer.
SuperSize Barbie, she's big fun.
SuperSize Barbie doll is big. You can dream of golden creations with her long, thick hair.
Glamorous hair.
SuperSize Barbie is big. You can borrow some of her jewelry.
Jewelry you wear.
Three sparkling fashion changes.
SuperSize Barbie, she's big fun.
SuperSize Barbie is 18 inches tall. SuperSize Barbie does not wear other Barbie costumes. New from Mattel.
Uh-oh, it's Wendy the running wonder.
You mean Wendy the spilling wonder. But I am ready.
Half a bounty?
Sure. Bounty does more what a towel's for. Half a sheet'll prove it.
5 miles, Rosie. Oops!
Here, Wendy.
Half a sheet? Gee, half's getting the whole spill. Quick, too.
Bounty absorbs quicker and more than any other two-ply towel.
Any other?
Prove it yourself. Bounty against the next best brand. Watch how fast Bounty drinks up the whole spill.
Hey!
Other towels just can't absorb as much as Bounty.
This towel's had it.
Sure, but even wet, Bounty's the quicker picker-upper.
Terrific. But is it strong?
Strong enough to lift these potatoes, even wet.
Rosie, Bounty's for me.
You got it, Wendy. Bounty does more of what a towel's for. Half a sheet'll prove it.
In America, abandoned cars litter the land. But the people in Lexington, Kentucky are removing 100 of them a month. We discard millions of used tires. But in New Jersey, they're turning old tires into playgrounds for children. Our streets and countryside have become dumping grounds for trash. But all across America, people are now recycling 8 million tons of it a year. We create staggering amounts of garbage. But in Virginia Beach, they turned a mountain of garbage into a recreational hillside. Pollution is destroying our beachfronts and waterways. But in Huntington, Long Island, they're planting seagrass, which cleanses the water for wildlife and man. The cure for pollution is people working together. For a brochure on what you can do, write, "Keep America Beautiful."
Killed old Musgrave?
Do you know very well he didn't. He
doesn't.
Stop clicking those needles.
Oh, Pat.
Take it easy, Sally. Now, look, don't worry a bit. I tell you, everything's going to be all right. Let's go, Inspector.
Mr. Holmes.
Steady, steady.
Aren't you on our side?
Yes, Sally.
Then why don't you do something?
Because Captain Vickery will be much safer in the local police station tonight than he would be in this house.
Oh, Mr. Holmes, what am I going to do?
Watson, get your sedative.
What am I going to do?
I'll get it at once.
Come along, Sally.
She's a bit upset, but she'll get over it.
You think so?
She'll have to. She's got an ordeal ahead of her. She has to go through that tiresome ritual tomorrow.
Ritual?
This is an old family ceremony, Mr. Holmes. Sally's next in line now that I'm head of the household. Blast this thing.
Miss Help?
Oh, yes, thanks. Knitting needle, isn't it?
Yes.
Handy little things. This is my heir. Sally has to recite a sort of formula over Jeff's body. In front of the fireplace in the library, in the presence of the entire household. Well, that's better.
Just what sort of formula?
Oh, it's not a meaningless word. It's a masquerade ritual, they call it. It's an old family custom. It's been handed down for generations.
You remember the words?
No, not at all.
But you had to speak them when your brother Jeffrey took over.
Yes, if that's right, I did. Let me see now. Who first shall find it? were better dead, who next shall find it perils his head. The last to find it defies dark powers.
Who first shall find it were better dead. Who next shall find it perils his head. The last to find it defies dark powers and brings good fortune to Hurlston Towers. Where was the light on the face of the messenger? Where did he speed? To guard the Queen's page. What foeman advanced? The bishop's page, rashly. And who to repel? The king's cautious page. What then the... disaster. Queen slaughters page.
No, no, sorry, Miss Sally. Page slaughters page.
Thank you, Brunton. Who came then to slay him? The bloodthirsty bishop. Where shall he go? Deep down below. Away from the thunder, let him dig under.
Once more into the breach, dear friends, once more. Happy day.
You drunken sot. The mouse has been ringing you for the past 10 minutes. Why don't you answer it?
Fly away, little gremlin.
You're the one who'll fly away if he ever catches you in this state. Oh, we saw that in. Hurry, hurry.
Coming, sir. Coming. One moment, sir. Mr. Holmes, come in, sir, come in. This is indeed an honor. I don't often have visitors. What can I do for you, sir?
Might stop that squeaking to begin with.
Yes, sir.
And perhaps you can tell me how you come to know the Musgrave ritual by heart.
Me, sir?
Yes, you. When Miss Sally forgot the lines today, you were the one who prompted her.
Well, sir, I memorized it.
Obviously. But why?
Because it has no meaning. I love things that have no meaning.
Thank you, Brunton. But supposing it did have a meaning, and suppose that meaning were tied up with the murder of Geoffrey Musgrave.
Oh, what a lovely idea. If I may say so.
You may, Brunton. You may also sit down.
Thank you, sir.
Oh, stop it. And look at me. No, here. You know the meaning of the Musgrave ritual.
Do I?
Well, don't you?
You'd be surprised at all the things I know.
What things?
No, you don't.
About the Musgraves?
That'd be telling. But here's to them anyway. All the Musgraves, past and present. Some of them were murderers, and some of them worse. But they all knew how to keep a secret. And so do I.
Brunton. I've been ringing for you for the past 10 minutes.
Sorry, sir, but the buzzer doesn't buzz.
That'll do, Brunton. You have your notice, do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Is that advisable, Mr. Musgrave?
Let me be the judge of that. He leaves Hurlston in the morning.
The morning's a long way off.
Farewell. A long farewell to all my greatness.
You've done it now, Alf Brunton. After all we've been through. How could I manage to do it all alone? What are you going to do?
What am I going to do? Thank you.
13 again.
Yes.
The roots of rock and roll, Chuck Berry.
Toll-free number, 1-800-323-1234. That's 1-800-323-1234. Or avoid COD charges and send $7.95 for records, $8.95 for 8-track tapes to Chuck Berry, Box 7500, Atlanta, Georgia, 30357. That's Chuck Berry, Box 7500, Atlanta, Georgia, 30357.
When Skipper picked up fleas and ticks, we picked up fleas and ticks.
I decided he should become an outdoor dog.
But the improved sergeant's flea and tick collar got him back in the house.
My dogs weren't fast enough to prevent fleas and ticks from getting a free ride. I put improved sergeant's collars on them. Now they'd rather run than scratch.
I never dreamed Fifi had fleas until one jumped on me. Now she wears two collars.
Protect your whole family from flea infestation and tick infestation with sergeant's collars. They're better than ever.
Free Braves tickets to the April 5th game at the stadium with Georgia Tech. Visit your Greater Atlanta Union oil dealer for free Braves tickets.
Among thy green rays, flow gently, I'll sing thee.
Sir Noel's attitude confuses me, Watson. She swears that she hasn't set eyes on Brunson since last night, and yet she seems completely unwilling to help us find him.
Quite so. She knows where he is as well as we do. I mean, as well as we don't.
I wonder.
You said that he was drinking last night. Wouldn't it be a good idea to try the pub?
Exactly where we're headed for, Watson.
I'm glad we thought of this. Even if we don't find Brunson.
I was afraid we shouldn't find him here.
Don't worry, old boy. I can do with a drink.
Your information, so could I. Gentlemen?
Hello, Doctor. Not looking for us, are you? Are you?
Well, no. As a matter of fact, we're looking for...
Brunson. You haven't seen him, have you?
Have we, Clavering? Have we?
Why should we? Morning, Gracie.
Morning, Doctor. What do you have?
A bottle of Bass and what's yours?
A pint of bitter, please.
And a pint of bitter. Oh, really?
Hello, a tame raven. You're a devil, are you? A kettle, are you?
Birds of prey, aren't they?
Yes, in a way, scavengers, rather. They can smell a carcass half a mile off.
Yeah, that they can and all. You should see Charlie here when there's a tasty bit outside in the street.
Shall we go sit down?
Dr. Watson.
He's over there, lass.
Thank you.
May I speak to you a moment, Mr. Holmes?
What's wrong, Sally?
We can't find my brother, Philip.
Did you look in his room?
That's the trouble. We had to force the door. It was locked on the inside.
Really?
Yes. Oh, you must come, Mr. Holmes.
Certainly, Sally, at once.
Do be quick. Something ghastly has happened. I know it. Oh, that dreadful bird. Please drive it away.
Watson. Take it away.
Away? Where to?
Anywhere. Into the pub. Just take it away.
Philip Musgrave.
What are they doing now? Doing now?
I don't know. They've stopped talking. Somebody's walking about in the upper hall. Heavy footsteps.
There's no doubt about it, Watson. Philip Musgrave had a visitor here last night. These footprints were made either by a very heavy man or a man carrying a very heavy burden.
That's right, Mr. Holmes. It's no good saying it ain't. The burden was Philip Musgrave's body, and these here footprints were made by Alfred Brunton.
It doesn't necessarily follow.
Oh, don't it?
Here, try that on your footprint.
And that's Alfred Brunton's shoe.
It's perfectly, Inspector.
Uh-huh.
But the fact that these prints were made by Brunton's shoes doesn't prove that Brunton's feet were in them.
Why not? Where should Brunton's feet be if not in his own shoe?
Well, they're not in them now, are they?
Look here, Holmes, let's use our intellect.
You what?
What's wrong with that? Let's stick to motive. That's my strong point. Now, this here Brunton had motive. Philip Musgrave gave him the sack, didn't he?
Did Geoffrey Musgrave also give him the sack?
What's that got to do with it?
Everything. The similarity of method in both murders shows they were the work of one man.
Well, that lets Vickery out. He was in jail at the time of this murder.
All right, Watson, all right.
Then Alfred Brunton's our man, just what I said.
What possible motive could Brunton have had for the murder of Geoffrey Musgrave?
Motive? Oh, bother motive. Who cares about motive? This case is as simple as ABC.
Is it? Then perhaps you could explain to us why these footprints lead up to a blank wall and never return.
What? You didn't think of that, did you, Inspector?
There's just one possible explanation.
I got it. Brunton murdered Musgrave right up against the wall. He hoisted the body over his shoulder, like this, you see, walks backwards, clean out of the room.
That's a very undignified position, Lestrade. Upsidaisy.
In a house as old as this, it's not unusual to find secret passageways that lead down through the walls. Hello, here we are. No, you don't. Come out of there.
What are you doing in there?
None of your business.
Answer me.
Obviously, she was looking for Brunton.
That's right. He hasn't left Musgrave Manor, I'm certain of that, sir. His clothes are still hanging in the wardrobe.
Don't you lie to me, woman. You've got him in there somewhere.
Don't come in there.
Why not?
You'll get lost.
Me lost? Oh, I like that.
He will get lost, sir.
Let him. Now listen to me. Where did you enter that passageway?
Through the old greenhouse in Lime Walk, sir.
Did Brunton know that?
No, he didn't.
Mrs. Brunton. Then why were you looking for him in there?
Yes, we've known all along that you were married to Brunton.
You know Philip Musgrave was murdered, don't you?
No.
Yes, you do, and you think Brunton did it?
No.
You think he carried him down through the greenhouse?
No, no.
Over to the garage?
No, he never.
And crammed his body in the rumble seat of that roadster?
Don't you try and put the blame on Alf.
I'll put the blame on both of you. You're in this together. You were in his room last night. I saw you there.
Only to talk about the ritual, sir. He thought that he got it all worked out.
Did he leave any notes, any record?
No. That is...
Oh, come on, out with it.
Only this, sir. I found it this morning under the soap dish on his washstand.
Hastily written.
Another jingle?
Yes. Obviously in some agitation. If any harm should come to me, fleshly or spiritual, seek and you will find the key in the Musgrave ritual.
The old ritual, there it is again.
Watson, we've got to find that ritual. It's the key to the whole business.
Just a minute. You can't talk to Sally.
Why not?
She was in such a state, I had to give her a hypo.
All right, come along.
...1977, a year of change, challenge, and confrontation. And Time magazine covered it all. In 1977, you met the families who got along and the families who didn't. Time showed you the easy riders and the hard liners, the majors and the minors, the pros and the cons. Time hailed a new chief, the team around him, and one who was benched. We remembered a lone eagle, celebrated 25 years of a queen, saw the courageous and the conquered, the righteous and the rebellious, the grim and the gay. And we sang Auld Lang Syne for some special friends we'll long remember. And now, Time brings you 1977, the year in review, a deluxe 96-page hardcover book that captures the year gone by and prepares you for the year ahead. You'll relive the year when we wrapped up Watergate and opened up Korea Gate, when two flew for the price of one, when a pipe dream became a reality and a blackout a nightmare. A year of grits, frits, splits, and the Sunday blitz. Time kept up with the Joneses, Smiths, and Browns, and took you to the Hounds, Boxers, Great Danes, Springers, Retrievers, and Pointers. In 1977, we ditched a big bomber and quarreled over a big ditch. We scaled new heights and plunged to new depths. It was a year of superhuman effort, and though nature sometimes turned against us, we knew that the force was with us.
The Year in Review, a colorful hardcover book you'll turn to again and again to relive the memorable events of 1977. And it's yours free when you subscribe to Time at the basic rate of 50 cents an issue, half the cover price. Only $14 will bring you 28 issues of Time.
Just call this toll-free number, 1-800-323-1234. We'll bill you later, and when we receive your payment, we'll send the Year in Review free as our gift. So call now and get the Year in Review for 77 and Time for 1978.
And it's another homer for Johnny Bench.
I've always believed you should do the best you can. That's why I feel good about recommending Batter Up to the parents of little leaguers. It's the best kind of batting practice for youngsters. It improves timing and helps develop a level swing. My name's on Batter Up, and I believe in it. I won't promise it'll make your youngster a big leaguer, but you never know.
Batter Up by Fonus and Little League approved. Make them quick.
There must be a copy of that ritual somewhere in this room. She had to learn it, you know.
Yes, you're right. Here it is.
I doubt it.
Empty.
Quite.
There's only one thing to do. Search the room.
Not the room, Watson. Her mind. We must search her mind. Obviously, she took great pains to hide that paper.
But why should she hide it?
Put yourself in her place. Her brother Jeffrey was murdered. The man she loves is accused of that murder and thrown into jail. On top of that, she finds her brother Philip murdered. What would your reactions be?
Well, naturally, I should be terribly upset.
Obviously. Excuse me. She's brought back to this house in a state bordering on hysteria. She comes through that door, goes to that desk, throws down her gloves. The first thing her eye lights on is the Musgrave ritual. In her mind, it's tied up with all the disasters that have befallen Hurston. She herself may be the next victim. She must hide that paper.
Well, quite right, but where?
Excuse me, sir.
Was she alone in this room at any time before you gave her the hypo?
Certainly not. Nora was here. She helped into bed while I went for my bag.
Good. Nora?
Yes, sir?
When you were alone with Miss Sally, what was the first thing she did?
Well, sir, she asked me to turn down her bed and lay out her nightdress.
And what was she doing in the meantime?
Let me think, sir. Oh, yes. She went over to her desk.
Mm-hmm. That was when she took the ritual from this envelope. What then, Nora?
Then she asked me to step over and draw the curtains. Why, someone's pulled them open.
Yes, I know. When you drew the curtains, you turned your back on her?
Sure, and it wasn't more than two shakes of a lamb's tail.
Long enough. When you were at the window, where was she?
She was sitting over here. Sitting right here, taking off her stockings. Oh, but she never left the chair. I'll kiss the book on it.
I've got it. She must have tucked that paper under this cushion. Must have changed her mind.
Obviously.
Well, she could have hidden it anywhere here.
What time is it when you brought her in here, Watson?
From the fence out here.
The clock was striking the quarter hour when I came in, sir. I definitely heard it.
This clock?
The same, sir.
Thank you, Nora. You may go. Obviously, this clock was running at 12:15. Just as obviously, it stopped at 12:20.
Huh?
When Nora turned her back, Sally reached across, opened the clock, and hid the ritual in here.
Amazing, Holmes.
Elementary, my dear Watson. Where fell the light on the face of the messenger? Where did he speed? Guard the Queen's page.
Gibberish, that's what it is.
Hokey pokey, penny a lump.
A thing like this, Watson, that's been handed down for centuries can't be mere gibberish. Who had entered the lists? The king's pale knight.
Pale poppycock.
I say, Watson. King, queen, knight, bishop.
Sounds like a game of chess to me.
Precisely. Where fell the light? The light, Watson. Follow the light. On the face of the messenger. Look at it, Watson. Look at it. Like a giant chessboard. This is no gibberish. These are chess terms, and that's the chessboard. The secret of the Musgrave murders is locked up in that floor. And by Jove, we've got the key to it. Who had entered the lists? The King's Pale Knight. White King's Knight to White King's Bishop 3. Your move, Dr. Sexton.
I really know nothing about the game.
Come on, Bob, it's great fun. You start from over here.
I'll show you. I'll show you. One, two, three, one.
Page into Black King 3. Your move, Clavering, into Black King 3, please, over there.
There's not to reason why.
Page slaughters page. Your move, Watson.
I take you, my dear. It's a good game, isn't it? Stop it, stop it. You mustn't giggle. Just be serious.
Your move, Clavering. You take Dr. Watson.
Too bad, Doctor.
Who came then to slay him? The bloodthirsty bishop. White Queen's Bishop, White King's Knight 5. That's my move. One, two. I say, Doctor, you moved, didn't you?
Did I? I don't think so.
Yes, I'm afraid you did.
Well, where was I? King, Bishop 3?
That's right.
Oh, yes, of course. So sorry.
3, 4, 5. Captain, it looks bad for you.
Aye, but where shall I go?
Where shall he go? Deep down below. Mrs. Howells, what's underneath this floor?
It's only an old cellar, sir. The entrance goes down behind that stair, but it's been locked up for centuries. One of the old Musgraves murdered his own brother down there.
Shh, listen. Hello, what's that?
It's Brunton. Alf, Alf, he's in that passageway over the fireplace. Are you there, Brunton?
Get me out! It's me, Lestrade. I'm lost. I'm all turned around.
You have been for years. Get him out of there, will you, Mrs. House, and give him a saucer of milk. Come here, Jenny. Stand on the square for me. And stamp on it. Keep stamping. Clavering, get your sound detector. Gentlemen, deep down below.
There's no been a soul here in a couple of hundred years.
Someone's been here. And in the last 24 hours.
Yeah, clean as a new pin.
Precisely. Dust of 200 years is on the walls. The floor's been swept clean. Obviously in an attempt to remove footprints.
Shh.
Listen. That's Jenny in the hall upstairs. Clavering. Let me have your sound detector.
So sorry.
You must find the exact spot under that square I marked in the hall. Don't move, anyone. Someone's moving about, interfering with what I'm trying to do. And perfectly still, everybody. Let me a hand.
Of course. Here, I'll take that.
Oh, thank you.
All right. I've got a little bit of here. That's all right.
Hello. Gracious me.
Here lies the body of Ralph Musgrave, Knight, Lord of the Manors of Hurlston.
This place used to be known as Hurlston Towers.
Netherfield and King's Hargrave, Anno Domini 1539. What we're looking for is underneath here. That's what the ritual meant by deep down below. It's a burial crypt. Up with it.
I say, there's somebody down there.
Who is it?
This is Brunton.
This is Brunton.
I don't know. Stay where you are. Brunton, all right.
Is he dead?
Yes. He's been dead for hours. Murdered. Hello? What's this? Henry, by the grace of God, King of Great Britain, France and Ireland, defender of the faith.
What have you found? Any clue? Any clue?
No. Just an old document. Hello? What's this?
Looks like some sort of writing.
Watson!
Coming.
Hold this for me, will you? Steady. There, on the floor by his right hand. See those marks in the dust? Like pin scratches made with his fingernail. Yes. Yes. See that stuff under his nail? He's trying to write something. By Jove! He did write something.
What is it?
Aye, tell us, man. What did he write?
I can't make it out. It's too faint.
Here, I've got good eyes. Let me.
Stay where you are, all of you. These marks must not be erased.
What are you going to do, Holmes?
I'm going to leave this just as it is until I can get the proper chemicals to bring out the words.
Have you no notion of what he tried to write?
Yes, I have. I think that Brunton, with his last strength, wrote the name of his murderer on that floor in his own blood.
Now, from General Mail Corporation, here's another exciting TV offer. Look at this breathtaking three-dimensional artwork. It's a painting, it's sculpture, it's popular string art. Can you imagine making something as beautiful as this yourself, even if you can't draw or paint, even if you're just a beginner? Well, now you can make it, and it's just one of three spectacular artworks in a craft kit that costs less than $10. And they're so easy to make. If you can just paste, pin, and string, your success is guaranteed. First, we send you two giant art prints of each magnificent painting. Just mount one print, cut out the other print, and paste it on the board easy enough for a child. And now, follow the simple pattern and tap nails on dots. String by following the numbers, and that's it. Just look at the magnificent three-dimensional detail. Now, here's exactly what you get. All the prints and patterns to make three giant artworks. First, you get the beloved sailing schooner. Then we send you the warm and wonderful city bridge, magnificent. And finally, we send you the brilliant, beautiful confetti ship. Remember, these kits are designed so that beginners and experts can get the same spectacular result. And listen to this. The prints alone for these three projects could cost $10 each. That's $30 worth of art prints. But now, you get all the prints plus the kits for the incredible price of just $9.95. But even that's not all. Act now, and we'll send you a fourth beautiful kit free, the award-winning Misty Harbor, an easy, fun project for the entire family. So that's three magnificent wall hangings plus the free Misty Harbor, and all for just $9.95 with a money-back guarantee if you're not delighted. Remember, the art prints alone could cost $40. Now here's how to order.
To order, call toll-free 1-800-323-1234. That's 1-800-323-1234. Or save COD charges and send just $9.95 to String Art, Box 7500, Atlanta, Georgia, 30357. That's $9.95 to String Art, Box 7500, Atlanta, Georgia. Or call 1-800-323-1234.
Hey, don't get up. You just had a baby.
Come on, I love to look at her.
Bill's helping Fred put up the crib. And I'll pick up some diapers for you.
Hey, thanks. Be sure to get Pampers, will you?
Oh, an expert already?
More hospitals use Pampers than any other diaper. To save on laundry and help keep clothes and bedding dry. For what I like best is the way Pampers Stay Dry Lining helps keep my baby's skin dry.
You really are an expert.
Ask any mother about Pampers dryness.
Lestrade.
12 o'clock.
I was just saying, Lestrade, that I should get into Newcastle, pick up my chemicals, and be back here not later than noon tomorrow.
Yes, Mr. Holmes.
Meanwhile, you all have your work cut out for you. Watson.
Yes?
You'll guard this door with your life.
Of course I will. With my what?
I said with your life.
Anything you say, Holmes?
There's no entrance to this cellar except through that doorway.
But Holmes, what I feel about...
Brunton's murderer's in this house. He's bound to make one last effort to get down there to erase those marks. Naturally. The Strad's men are posted outside. They'll see to it that nobody leaves this house.
Concentration camp.
My men have orders to shoot, if necessary. I'll be outside myself, keeping watch.
Sexton, your post will be at Miss Sally's door. And remember, she's in more danger than anyone here.
Don't worry, I'll look after her, Mr. Holmes.
Good night.
Good night, Holmes.
Good night. Luck.
Dr. Watson, if you want any help, sing out.
I don't mind saying I'd feel a lot safer if I had a gun on me.
I always keep mine ready. Oh, good night, Bob. Keep awake, old man.
I will.
That's funny. Striking 12 again.
This monkey business.
I didn't lock you in.
Well, doors don't lock themselves.
They do in this house.
What are you doing down here anyway?
I'm worried. It's about Langford.
Langford?
Yes, he's got it into his head that this is a Jap prison camp. He's got that filthy rope and he's bound and determined to go out the window.
He can't do that. This crowd's men will shoot him.
He may be out already.
I'll head him off.
Then again, he may not be.
Perhaps you're right.
Let me go.
No. He'll be shot.
I'll go.
No, you'll be shot.
Oh, really?
Let's both go.
Oh, I can't leave here. You stay where you are. I'll go and call Lestrade. Remember, Clavering, stay where you are. Look here, Constable. I'm Dr. Watson.
Are you now? Well, I'm Mrs. Miniver. Come along to the inspector.
Gross impertinence.
Useless, I assure you. There's nothing written on the floor. It was just a ruse of mine to bring Brunton's murderer here. Permit me. As the most ruthless killer in England, you deserve some of the light.
Killer? I? Oh, I say, you seem to forget that my life was also attempted.
And a very neat trick it was to divert suspicion from yourself. But it struck me as odd that the man who murdered both Musgraves with such a sure hand should have missed so badly in your case. Unless, of course, you yourself were the murderer.
Oh, but that's ridiculous.
Then, too, it seemed curious that you, a doctor, examined both bodies and failed to report the real cause of death.
And that was?
A cisternal needle thrust up into the brain between the base of the skull and the first cervical vertebra. I had the unpleasant duty of removing this piece of needle from Philip Musgrave's head. It couldn't be yours by any chance, could it?
I never owned one.
Oh, yes, you did. I saw it in your case. The night I came into this house. Just after Geoffrey Musgrave was found murdered. It wasn't broken then. It was only when you killed Philip Musgrave that you lost a piece of it.
Oh, nonsense. Why should I go around sticking needles into people?
A fair enough question, Doctor. Among nice people, murder, like matrimony, generally has a motive. And in this case, the motive was matrimony.
Oh, you mean Miss Sally?
I do.
Oh, I see. So you think it's a case of murder for profit, do you?
Precisely.
My dear Holmes, that won't do. The Musgraves are land poor. Everybody knows that.
Exactly. But everybody didn't know what you knew. You worked out the meaning of the Musgrave ritual.
I have? Oh.
Yes, you have. You claimed you knew nothing about the game of chess. When I suggested you'd moved off your proper square, you promptly named King's Bishop 3, and what's more, moved back onto it.
Oh, nonsense. Why should I have stepped out of my square in the first
place? Break up my move, spoil my game, and prevent me from finding what you had already found.
And that was?
The old land grant I took from Miss Box, which would have made Sally Musgrave, upon the death of her brothers, the richest woman in England. Well, what's that?
Don't tell me you found another needle.
No, no. Just a button. Wouldn't be yours, would it?
Mine? Give it to me.
Thank you.
Would you mind telling me why you think I was down here with Brunton?
No, not at all. As I see it, you killed Philip Musgrave in his own room, carried his body down through the secret passageway, out through the greenhouse, into the garage, where you crammed it into the rumble seat of that roadster. But unfortunately for you, you had a witness. Brunton was there, sleeping off his drunk, nursing a grudge against Philip Musgrave. Brunton became your accessory. But you didn't want an accessory, so you lured him down here with a promise to share the Musgrave treasure with him and exit Brunton.
Very ingenious, Mr. Holmes. You seem to have everything. Except perhaps the negligible item of proof.
Suppose we leave that to the jury.
Suppose we do. Shall we go?
After you. Oh, by the way, don't forget your torch.
Oh, thanks. I don't suppose it occurred to you
that you were taking a bit of a chance coming down here all alone with a suspected murderer?
One has to take chances in my profession, Doctor. You see, I couldn't possibly risk sharing my little plot with anybody.
Not even with Dr. Watson?
Oh, particularly not with Dr. Watson. If he'd known what was up tonight, he'd have been so elaborately mysterious, he'd have given the whole show away. As a matter of fact, I had the devil's own time luring him away from that door upstairs so that we could be alone.
That's all I wanted to know.
Automobile is a big investment. If you have a vinyl top on your car, you probably paid at least $100 extra for it. But constant exposure to the hot bleaching rays of the sun, the pounding of rain, sleet, and snow, and the effects of road acids and salts has made the top look old, weather-beaten, dull. Now there's a product called New Vinyl that is made specifically for the care and protection of vinyl tops. All you do is wipe New Vinyl on. There's no rubbing, no buffing. It's so quick and easy to use, you can cover the entire top of the car in just a couple of minutes. New Vinyl is not a wax. It's a clear vinyl coating that restores the luster, makes your top look like new again. But best of all, just one application will protect your vinyl top month after month. Look, we ran this car through 50 consecutive car washes, yet in spite of all the scrubbing, the harsh detergents, and steam, you can see that this side, treated with New Vinyl, still shines like new. Yes, you'll find many uses for New Vinyl. Restores new car beauty to your car's vinyl upholstery. You can protect furniture from stains and scuff marks. Use it on shoes, boots, purses, even vinyl wall covering. And it works just as well on genuine leather, too. This one bottle will keep your car top looking showroom new for 3 years or more. And it's only $2.98. New Vinyl is guaranteed to perform to your complete satisfaction or return it for a full refund.
Get New Vinyl only at Super X Drugs, Dunaway's, Woolworth Wilco, Reed's Drugs, Eckerd Drugs.
Curls are back. Oh.
Curls are back, and Tony's got them, and you can get them any way you want them.
Tony has a wave for any look you want.
Boop-de-boop curls.
Really loose curls.
Or all body in one big curve.
Boop-de-boop curls.
Boop-de-boop curls. So swing and
swirl.
Curls are back, and Tony's got 'em. Tony
Hoey. Wrigley Spearmint Gum says hello.
Wrigley Spearmint? We all like it. Me and all my friends.
Try sharing some Wrigley Spearmint Gum. You're gonna like the way it says hello.
Wrigley Spearmint? It's got a fresh, clean taste. It's our way to say hello.
Everyone likes the way it says hello. Wrigley Spearmint Gum. We all like the way it says hello.
Stay where you are. I'm afraid I have no choice, Dr. Sexton. Look here. You're not really going to kill me, are you? They'll hear you.
Who will?
That was a bad slip you made, letting me know you were so completely alone. And you're really going to kill me. I'm afraid I have no choice, Mr. Holmes. But as you said, I've no evidence against you. No proof, no proof at all.
You forget the needle and the button. Bring them here, please. Not too close. Now put them in my pocket. Curious about that button. It is off my coat, of course. Can't think how I never missed it. Poor old brother. Brunton. He didn't struggle much. Now, Phil Musgrave was different. The needle broke off and I didn't have time to probe for it.
But you've got both of them now, the button and the needle. Why kill me?
Now, step back, just a bit. Against the wall. Now, if you stand perfectly still, I think I can manage this with one shot.
Confession, Watson?
Every word, Holmes. And I heard all the rest, sir.
Good. Let me congratulate you on an extraordinary catch.
That's right, Mr. Holmes. It's no good saying it ain't.
I'm afraid I underestimated you, Holmes. Pity.
Yes. Those blank cartridges were a cheap sort of trick, I grant you. But it wasn't easy to let you take my gun away from me without seeming to hand it to you. That's why I let you take the torch first. I knew you'd snap it off.
Yes, we told you we were taking an awful risk.
Well, we had to have a confession. And these egomaniacs are always so much more chatty when they feel they have the upper hand. Shall we go?
I can't make head nor tail of it. Can you, Pat?
Well, it looks like an old land grant.
It's really a crown grant.
What I don't understand is why the Musgraves didn't claim the land ages ago.
Obviously, Watson, one of them died before passing on the meaning of the ritual to his heir. The words remained, but the sense was lost.
I wonder why he left the grant down there where he found it.
What good would it have done him? So long as your brothers lived. Once they were out of the way and you came into the property, he expected to marry you.
I like that. Whatever made him
he
think...
He thought himself irresistible.
Precisely. It's not unheard of in cases of egomania.
I suppose then he meant to rediscover the crown grant.
At the proper time, yes. And then enjoy his wife's millions.
Did you say millions?
I did. Look here. About 80,000 acres of the richest soil in England.
But aren't there people on it?
Yes, farms, villages, even a factory town, with hundreds of workmen's cottages.
Is this thing legal?
Perfectly. Of course, it'll drag on through the courts.
Just a moment. The people on this land, they put their money into it, their life work. It's their homes I'll be taking.
Yes.
Do you think I'm going to kick these people out?
You let poor little Sally throw away a fortune.
My dear fellow, I had nothing to do with it. The girl, more power to her, acted on her own.
Oh, grand gesture, one she may regret.
I don't think so, Watson. There's a new spirit abroad in the land. The old days of grab and greed are on their way out. We're beginning to think of what we owe the other fellow, not just what we're compelled to give him. The time's coming, Watson, when we shan't be able to fill our bellies in comfort while other folk go hungry, or sleep in warm beds, while others shiver in the cold. When we shan't be able to kneel and thank God for blessings before our shining altars, while men anywhere are kneeling either physical or spiritual subjection.
You may be right, Holmes. I hope you are.
And God willing, we'll live to see that day, Watson.
We hope you enjoyed the Sherlock Holmes Theater today and that you will join us tomorrow afternoon for Everything's Ducky, starring Mickey Rooney, Buddy Hackett, and Jackie Cooper on Movie 17.
TV Records presents Conway Twitty.
Hi, folks. You know, my friends at TV Records have put together a great new collection of my 20 biggest hits. In this deluxe two-record set called Conway Twitty 20 Certified Number One Hits.
Here's the country music offer America has been waiting for. Conway Twitty with his 20 Certified Number One Hits. My heart and prayer will be the day you pass. This deluxe two-record set contains all of Conway's biggest, every one a certified number one country song.
Hello, darling.
It's been a long time. Joni, Joni, please don't cry.
Remember, you can't buy this great new collection in any store at any price. You can get my 20 certified number one hits from TV Records only if you act now.
In this truly unique collection, you'll get all of Conway's great number one hits on two stereo records, only $7.99. Eight-tracker cassette tape, only $9.99. Conway 20's 20 certified number one hits from TV Records.
I hope you enjoy this exciting new collection of my biggest hits, and here's my friend to tell you how to order.
For quick delivery, call toll-free 1-800-323-1234. That's 1-800-323-1234. Call now. Operator standing by. Save the COD charges and $7.99 for the records. $9.99 for a track or cassette tape to Conway Twitty. Box 7500, Atlanta, Georgia, 30357. That's Box 7500, Atlanta. Or call toll-free 1-800-323-1234. Order now.
Employers are needed to hire women on the pre-prison release program. For more information, call 894-4881.